I've been asked a few times to make a video on what is dry bulb, wet bulb, and relative humidity, and where they should be measured in HVAC applications. Let's start with dry bulb. Dry bulb is the temperature of the air around you, also known as ambient air temperature. So any air around you, you put a thermometer in the air, that is the dry bulb. As long as your thermometer is not in the sun, so it's not getting affected by some other heat source, and as long as you're not in some kind of a wet situation where there's a lot of moisture in the air that can also skew the temperatures. If you're adding refrigerant to an air conditioner and it's asking you for the condenser dry bulb temperature, all it's asking for is the ambient temperature around the condenser unit outside. So you would literally take a thermometer, any thermometer, I use a psychrometer usually, and just put it on the side of the condenser where it's sucking air in and measure the temperature going into the unit. Preferably a side of the unit where it's shady, where it's in the shade, not in the sun, so the sun doesn't affect the temperature. As for wet bulb temperature, it will almost always be lower than the dry bulb temperature because it also considers evaporation. The easiest way to understand this is to look back on how they measured wet bulb back in the day by using those sling psychrometers. Basically, it's a regular thermometer, metal probe, but they put a little sock over it, a piece of cloth, and then they dip that thing into water and swing it around like nunchucks. And that swinging around motion causes the water in that cloth to start to evaporate. And as the water is evaporating, it also takes some of the heat from the metal probe with it. Luckily, nowadays, we don't have to intimidate homeowners with swinging psychrometers because we have digital psychrometers that do the reads automatically without us having to swing anything. And I'll show you a quick demonstration of the one I use at the end of the video. So to put it simply, wet bulb is basically dry bulb temperature, but it also considers evaporation of what effect that has on it. Which also brings us to relative humidity percentage. All that is it's telling you how much moisture is in the air. Zero being really dry, there's no moisture in the air at all, and 100% being it's super saturated, water can't even evaporate because there's so much moisture in the air. And I'm sure you've all experienced high relative humidity at some point. That's when you feel really sticky. And the reason you're feeling really sticky is because the sweat that your body is producing is not evaporating because there's so much moisture in the air. It just stays on your body, giving you that sticky effect. Relative humidity percentage is just like dry bulb. You pretty much just measure it wherever you're standing or wherever you're currently at. As for the wet bulb, for HVAC, the place where you want to check the wet bulb temperature, if your chart is asking you for that, your refrigeration chart, the best place to check that is at the filter, right before the A-coil. So basically wherever your filter slot is, you can just pull that filter out and stick your psychrometer into that slot to get your wet bulb reading. That's the best place to get it. If you can't get there for some reason, you could also just pick any return grill in the house where it's sucking air in and just put your psychrometer right in front of there, and that will be a good place to get your wet bulb reading. And as promised, let's take a look at my digital psychrometer, the one that I use. I've been using this for about 8 years and it works great. Very easy, very simple to use. So right when you turn it on, it shows us the relative humidity percentage, and as you can see, it's about 70%. The reading on the bottom, that's our dry bulb, the ambient temperature, which is about 79 degrees right now. If we press DP and WB, that brings us to dew point. I did not cover dew point in the video, but basically dew point is the temperature at which water will start to condense on something. So if you put a water bottle that is 68 degrees on the inside, it will start to condense on the outside. But if we press this button again, that brings us to the wet bulb. And as you can see, our wet bulb outside right now is about 73 degrees, which is 7 degrees lower than the ambient temperature. So as you can see, those reads are super easy to get if you have a digital psychrometer. If you don't already have one and you need one, I would recommend this brand. It's never failed me. This thing works great. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. And if you're still here and not in the comment section below, my friend just asked me what the 9th letter of the alphabet is. It was just a guess, but I was right. I also have a bunch of jokes about unemployed people. Unfortunately, none of them seem to work.